Is there an ideal type of water to keep you hydrated? To figure it out, I spent 5 days trying 5 different types of water to find the best one. Thank you to Skillshare for sponsoring today's video. So it's hot girl summer. Literally, it's so hot outside. Like today it's 27 degrees. I am so thirsty all the time. So I'm naturally trying to drink more water. Look at my water bottle. I got 800 milliliter. You can't read that, can you? Can you read that? 800. Just trying to stay hydrated, right? But usually it goes a little something like this. Yeah, it just goes right through me. So in this video, let's figure out how to be less thirsty. Let's hit the books. So I thought that I needed to figure out how much water to drink, whether 8 cups is actually enough. But then I quickly found out that it's really dependent on our lifestyles and day-to-day activities. So it's sort of impossible to arrive at some universal standard. Really, we should just drink when we're thirsty. So it was kind of surprising to learn that there isn't really this golden number or amount of water that you should be drinking. So if it isn't about how much water you should be drinking, what about different types of water? Like, you know what I mean. Nowadays, there isn't just like plain water. Tap water, filtered water, soda water, yada yada yada. So this week, I am going to become a lab rat. A wet lab rat.
Be seeing you, my friend.
And I'm gonna spend each day dedicated to consuming one type of water, specifically tap water, soda water, electrolyte water, purified water, and no water. You can thank Sabrina for that one. I think this is gonna be a rough week, to say the least. All in the name of science. Am I right?
What have I gotten myself into?
Chaotic. Oh, production value. To be super transparent, I am filming this several days later after I've completed my challenge. Day one, tap water. Oh, good old tap water. Day one, tap water. This is kind of a control day in our experiment. It's what most of us drink, so I'm just gonna report on how thirsty I feel throughout the day.
I don't feel like I want to drink more water. Like, I don't feel thirsty, that's for sure.
A solid B tier. It did its job, but you know, we didn't really have anything to compare to. So, you chill here for now, okay? Good stuff. Next. Day two, soda water. This is more about disproving something that I've read. There's a study that claims that soda water is just as hydrating as normal water, and I don't think that's true. Let's see.
So I just came home from my morning workout, and I realized that today is soda water day. I'm so thirsty.
I can report that drinking soda water after workout, personally, was not my favorite thing.
It's so difficult to do with one hand.
The bubbles weren't very satisfying to drink. And throughout my day, my stomach hurt a little bit because of all the bubbles.
I've been drinking my soda water and coffee together. My stomach hurts.
Also could be my diet, not too sure, but I can say with certainty that I did not enjoy drinking only soda water for a day.
Okay, so I was absolutely correct. F tier. You saw what happened. The bubbles did not agree with my stomach. I'm sure it was hydrating, but no. You stay there.
Day three, electrolyte water. It's marketed as being very hydrating. Electrolytes are elements like sodium or magnesium that conduct electricity when dissolved in water. They help control fluid levels in your body, but you can lose them, especially when sweating.
Hello. Yes, we're in a car today. It's 3 p.m. I have not had any water today. I've only had coffee. All I know is that it's really hot today. It's 27 degrees and I haven't had any water, so I'm gonna go get some electrolyte water for today. Let's go get hydrated because I think I'm gonna pass out really soon.
Oh, hello. Got my little tablets.
do a little unboxing. These are electrolyte tablets. They only come in lemonade flavor, so all of my water for today is going to taste like lemonade.
Wasn't a big fan of that, but that's my fault. That's not the fault of the tablets. I just made a mistake. But I drank the glass of water and I felt okay. And then it wasn't until like several hours later that I was like, maybe I should drink some more water. So I made another glass and that was the end of that day. I don't know if I didn't drink water because I wasn't thirsty or because I didn't like the water that I was drinking. I'm not too sure here.
I had high hopes for this day, mostly because Sabrina really hyped it up in my brain that electrolyte water was gonna be some magical substance that would just keep me super quenched. Well, you see, I put it on D tier because I just didn't like the taste of it and I ended up moving on now.
Dark, let's pop the light on.
Whoa.
It is 1 p.m. I have not had any water yet because I need to go collect it from the river. You may be thinking, isn't she gonna get sick if she just drinks water directly from the stream? Well,
day 4, purified stream water. This water has been filtered to remove impurities like heavy metals, chemicals, and bacteria to various degrees so that it's drinkable and tastes fresh. But you don't want to filter your drinking water too much because it removes naturally occurring minerals that help keep us hydrated.
Let's go get some water before I pass out.
Honestly, I think this is a pretty ridiculous idea, mostly because it's something that I've never really considered doing, and I am not much of a backcountry camper, if that's the right word. When I go camping, we bring the water with us. So this is new territory for me here.
Running water is a good sign.
Okay, that works. This is definitely not how you're supposed to do this.
Stream water secured. I have so many bug bites, but I got my water. I'm so tired.
I made it home. I was going to do it at the river, but I am not that skilled. So I got my water here, filter. I think we just open this. Screw this on, like that. Squeeze it. Closer look at that. Oh yes. The sweet sound of nature. All right, I got about 400 milliliters of water. I guess all that's left to do is taste it. Tastes like water. Cool. It went a lot better than I expected, actually.
Honestly, solid A tier. Better than tap water, I think. I was really surprised that it tasted like water. That sounds really dumb to say, but it did. It just tasted like regular water.
Day 5, no water. So Sabrina sent me this Scientific American article about how some cultures derive most of their water from food, because liquid water is scarce for a variety of reasons. And so she challenged me to try it, because she is a bad friend. I'm loading up on lots of cucumbers, apples, other fruits, all the food that I can.
This is really great framing. I know.
Today started off like any normal day. However, I did notice myself getting a little tired throughout the day. Maybe because I did not have enough water. Who knows?
This day kind of sits in the middle for me because it wasn't great, it wasn't super bad. I did get a little delirious in the middle of the day, but overall, it was just meh. I'm still not really sure what the best type of water to drink is. There's so many factors that changed each day. This was not a very scientific experiment. Anyways, I figured it was time to talk to an expert. So I emailed this person and here's what she had to say.
So my name is Tammy, or Tamara Hugh Butler, and I'm an associate professor of exercise physiology at Wayne State University in downtown Detroit. Water is essential for life. Period, end of story, whether they go to Mars or whatever. So it actually doesn't matter what form it's in, as long as you get the H2O or the liquid part of it. We have oxygenated water, alkaline water, you know, acid water, like electrolyte water. We have all these different forms, but again, your body just needs the H2O. The tap is probably safer than the stuff that you'll actually get in a bottle because it's more heavily regulated.
Do those different types of water, like, do they hydrate you differently at all? Like, is there any difference in them?
No, drink the beer, drink the soup. All of that, drink the tea and the coffee, it's all gonna do the same thing. And everything else is like fluff, you know? If you don't need the minerals and the vitamins, you're gonna pee that out too. So every one water is not better than the other. But the confusing part is, you know, we all focus on how much water. But the secret is your body, when we talk about fluid balance, it's actually the balance of water to salt. That's important to your body. You know, what we eat and drink, our body tries to regulate the perfect balance. And that balance is by, okay, we eat and drink, but how much we actually pee out. But if you need it, you'll get like super thirsty.
I have been overthinking this whole water hydration thing from the beginning. If I've learned anything throughout this week, it's that honestly, it doesn't really matter how you get your water. As long as you get it in your body and you feel hydrated, drink when you're thirsty, don't drink when you're not thirsty. I just want to say that it's been a week and I missed water, regular tap water. And I wanted to share this moment of me drinking normal water on camera. So cheers. More. Something that Tamara said that really stuck with me is just drink the water that you like to drink. Don't make the mistake of drinking soda water for a full day because my stomach hurt so much that day. The interview with Tamara was so insightful and I wish that I could share more of what she had mentioned here in this video. But luckily, if you do want to watch the full interview, we're going to be uploading an audio version to Spotify and the full video on our YouTube channel. I'll leave you with this. Have a hot girl summer, but just remember to stay hydrated. Okay, bye. You already knew. Stick around for the ad read. Oh. Hello there. I hope you liked that video. And if you did, you should stick around because we're thanking Skillshare for sponsoring today's video. I'm going to be painting some watercolors. You know why? Because I took a Skillshare course to make my watercolor art better. I haven't painted since high school. I'm gonna reveal what I make at the end. You're not gonna be able to see, but you gotta stick around for the full ad read too. It'll be worth it, I promise. Skillshare is an online learning community with thousands of classes, you know, meant for people like yourself and myself, creatives, lifelong learners, want to explore new topics, get better at things you're passionate about, like photography, graphic design, painting. Hopefully my painting is good. I followed this class by Marie Noel Worm called Abstract Watercolor Paintings Explore Through Freeform and Plan Process. It reminds you to trust your creative instincts and have fun while painting. Skillshare is curated specifically for learning, meaning there's no ads and they're always launching new premium classes so you can stay focused and follow wherever your creativity takes you.
Come on, I feel like I don't really need to sell you on this that much. Skillshare is great. Like, my art? Amazing. Oh yeah, great stuff.
The first 1,000 people to put the link in the description will get a full month free trial. So, you know, whether you want to deepen an existing passion or get lost in creativity, get started with Skillshare. Let me show you my art. Whee! Ah! Okay. That's enough art for today.